Great, I think we can kickstart the session for the day. And without a further ado, let me first introduce myself. My name is Amit Chaturvedi. I'm the Associate Director of Client Relations for destinations like UK, Ireland, and New Zealand for IDP South Asia region. And I'm very pleased to have an eminent speaker from National College of Engineering, National College of Ireland, sorry. And then the topic today we have is the next generation leaders, opportunities for business graduates in Ireland. It's a very exciting topic to hear from an eminent speaker, giving you insights on the quality of education in Ireland, what one can look forward to as a student when you get into Ireland. And of course, we have team from NCI today to take on other questions which we have. It's an absolute pleasure to introduce Dr. Colette Darcy, who's the Dean of the School of Business and is a Senior Lecturer in the Human Resource Management at the National College of Ireland. Thank you very much, Dr. Darcy, for sparing time to come on this platform today to interact with some existing or some of the students who have made applications and a lot of prospective students who I'm sure after listening to you will be excited to ensure that Ireland is one of their priority destinations to come for international education. I'll quickly share some details about Dr. Darcy. As I said, she's a dean from the School of Human Resources Management. She's a former Government of Ireland scholar and was awarded the European Foundation for Management Development, Emerald Outstanding Doctoral Thesis Award for her research examining employees' fairness perception and claiming behavior. Colette is a graduate of Trinity College Dublin and the University of Limerick. Prior to returning to academia, she worked in management consultancy for a number of years and was recently appointed an honorary fellow of the Recruitment Federation of Ireland. She has published her work in a number of top international peer-reviewed journals, including Human Resource Management and the International Journal of Human Resource Management. Her main research interests include talent management, human resource management, work-life balance, and organizational justice. So I'm sure with the kind of strengths Colette has, I'm sure she'll find a lot of people who come across in this discussion. If you have concerns and questions, if you have your subject or your interest in her areas, which are talent, human resource development, work-life balance, critical these days as everyone is working from homes, and organizational justice, where we all keep talking about various aspects into the organization we all are into. I'm sure you all will get greater insights into these areas. And of course, a lot to hear about NCI. I hand it over now to Dr. Darcy. And good luck to you, Dr. Darcy. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ahmed. That was very nice of you, a very lovely introduction, and I very much appreciate it. I might just start by sharing my slides with you. But as you've rightly pointed out, this is a very exciting time in the Irish economy. We're seeing quite a boom in terms of our international foreign direct investment. And that means that we have lots of international organizations basing their European headquarters within Ireland, particularly within Dublin. And that means there's huge opportunity for graduate students, and particularly international graduate students, because these organizations really embrace the idea of diversity and really want students who have experience of international travel, who have maybe additional languages, that are used to working in multicultural environments, and so can bring greater ideas and innovation in terms of what they're looking to do. So today, as we go through this presentation, I'll be giving you some insights in terms of what I see as being the big issues for organizations within the Irish sector and where I believe the potential is for graduates. But let me begin, I suppose, firstly, by giving you a bit of a background to the National College of Ireland, which is the institution, obviously, that I represent. And as I've been introduced, I'm the Dean of the Business School. And we're a very busy business school and also a very ambitious one. And I think that that is a good thing to say at the outset. So we were founded in 1951. We're a government-funded, not-for-profit organization, and we're currently touching around 6,000 students, which isn't small by any measure. But we represent about 80 different nationalities within our institution. So we're a very multicultural institution. And again, we firmly believe, particularly from a business education perspective, that having different views and different perspectives in the classroom really adds to the learning that students can gain. Because we want our students to have a global perspective. We want our students to be able to understand the world in which they work and to be able to navigate their way within international business to allow them to be successful in that regard. So having different diversity and different nationalities in our classroom really adds to that blend and mix. And it's something that we try to encourage. We'll talk about the specific programs that we offer within the School of Business, but they cover international business, accounting and finance, marketing, human resource management, and psychology. And again, we see in National College of Ireland that there's greater growth in terms of organizations looking for graduates from these particular areas. And those individuals who can use their skill sets in a slightly different way. So even if you have a degree, for example, in psychology, we're seeing more and more organizations looking to those graduates because they see that they have a skill set around how the brain works. So in marketing, for example, how consumer behaves, why a consumer would buy one product over another is very much within psychology. Within HR, how do we motivate people better? Again, very much linking back to psychology. And within the National College of Ireland, we work hard to try to build those interrelationships between the different subject areas. So you have a much more grounded, I suppose, approach in terms of how you go about doing the business that you do. While I'm not here to speak about my colleagues in the School of Computing, we also have a School of Computing in the college, and their strengths would really lie in the areas of computing, data science, data analytics, cloud computing, cybersecurity, and fintech. And again, there are huge overlaps between those areas and that of business. And we're working hard as a college to try to make sure that the students who engage, whether it's in School of Computing programs or business programs, that they develop an awareness, if not an in-depth awareness, certainly an awareness of how those other sides of the business might operate. So within the School of Business, we offer honours bachelor degrees, which are traditionally 3 years long, although there is the option to do an additional year as an internship year. And then we would also offer 1 year master's degrees. And it's important to note that all of our programmes are globally recognised. All of our programmes currently are mapped to the Irish quality and qualifications framework, which is also transferable to the European quality framework. So all of our degrees, whether they're undergraduate degrees or postgraduate degrees, are all recognized internationally and are approved and accepted in those areas. So why would you choose to come and study in National College of Ireland? Well, there are a number of reasons, but I would point to the excellence of the education. The education standards both in Ireland in general, but more particularly in the National College of Ireland. We are known as the Isle of Saints and Scholars. And again, I think that speaks to the excellent educational reputation that Ireland has. The National College of Ireland itself, though, we are currently a 4-star institution in terms of QS star ranking, with 5 stars in employability, social responsibility, and facilities. And really, it's our employability, I suppose, star that we're particularly proud of. We work very hard to ensure that our graduates are employability ready. We work with employers to understand what their needs are so that we can incorporate the skill sets that we know they're looking for within our students. And we also work very hard with our careers team to make sure that from the very start of your program of study with us in National College of Ireland, that you have an eye towards the future and what it is that you're hoping to achieve in terms of your career goals. Because ultimately, this experience is quite an expensive one. It's an investment in you, in your future. And we understand that you want to maximize that. So again, we work quite hard with the various different professional bodies where possible to ensure that we have professional accreditation attaching to our programs. So for our human resource management programs, for example, they are CIPD accredited, the Chartered Institute of Personnel and Development, who are based out of the UK. We also have accounting C body accreditations. They're particularly the ACCA, which is globally recognized, and the Chartered Accountants of Ireland. And then in relation to our psychology program, we would be members of the Psychological Society of Ireland, which again is very important for anyone wishing to pursue a postdoctorate award in psychology or to practice in a clinical way within the psychology profession. I mentioned at the outset that as a college and an institution, we're very ambitious and we're ambitious for our future as much as yours. So currently we have over 70% of our full-time faculty are PhD. And within that, the majority of those are very research active. So it's important for me as the dean of the school that the faculty that we place in front of our students are the very best that they can be, that those faculty are PhD qualified and that they're research active in their area, so that they can speak to students in terms of the most up-to-date research, contributing towards that research themselves. Okay. So you might ask, where are we? Where is Ireland? So Ireland is a small country on the periphery of Europe. We're on the western edge of Europe. We're an English-speaking country, which now that the UK has decided to leave the European Union, makes us the only English-speaking country within the EU. We're a very safe country. We would have very, very low crime rates, and it's generally a very peaceful place. There's quite a relaxed pace of life within Ireland. We work hard, but we also play hard, we like to say. And you'll notice that today I'm wearing my green top because yesterday was St. Patrick's Day, which is our national day festival. So again, it's a day when we celebrate all things Irish, our culture, our academic achievements, our heritage, and it's just a very wonderful day, a nice way to celebrate, as I say, all things Irish. I mentioned also that we were known as the Isle of Saints and Scholars, so we have excellent educational standards, and that's going right back through the centuries. And I also had mentioned at the outset that we're seeing an increasing number of international multinationals basing their European headquarters within Ireland, and particularly within Dublin. And that's a recognition, I suppose, of the excellent education system that we have. The fact that our population is generally quite young and seen to be quite adaptable and quite versatile. But it's also a great endorsement of Ireland as an economy. It's booming at the moment, and we're seeing very high levels of employment, and again, very high levels of living standards. Again, whether you're a student or whether you're an organization, Ireland is increasingly the gateway to Europe. And certainly for those students who travel to Ireland to study, one of the main benefits of being based in Ireland is that you can use your time when you're not in class to travel around the rest of Europe. And again, I suppose travel is an education in itself. And we would encourage all of our students where possible to embrace the opportunity they have while they're in Europe to see the different parts of it where possible. You also have the opportunity while studying Ireland to take on some part-time work. And at the completion of your program, if you be successful, there are graduate work visas available also. Dublin itself is very, it's a bustling city, it's the capital city. It's probably quite small in terms of comparisons to India. We would have about 1,000 or a million people living in Dublin city and in the environment around it. But again, it's quite a buzzy place, quite a busy place. And again, I can't say strongly enough, a very friendly environment in which to study and to live. The college itself is situated right in the very heart of Dublin city. So our campus is within the IFSE area, which is the International Financial Services Centre area. And this was set up some years ago by the Government of Ireland specifically to attract international financial institutions to Dublin to set up. And it's been phenomenally successful, so much so that it is viewed as a competitor to the City of London and also then to our colleagues on mainland Europe. But over the last number of years, we've also seen this development of what has been referred to as the Silicon Docks. And the Silicon Docks really refers to this idea of these large multinationals, high-tech nature who have chosen to set up in the Irish context within Dublin, and again to avail of an English speaking workforce, but also to be a gateway to Europe. And I think this map really demonstrates just how central we are in terms of our location and just how much we are in the heart of everything. And when I talk about the kinds of employers who take on graduates from the National College of Ireland, many of those are our neighbours. So many of those are individuals who are next door to us and know our reputation and are happy to take on our graduates because they know us so well. So you can see we're on the left-hand side of the screen. The National College of Ireland is right beside all those very large, mainly financial institutions, the PwCs of the world, Citi, Oracle, BNP Paribas. But again, on the other side of the Liffey, and that is the Liffey, the main river that runs through the heart of Dublin City. So a 5-minute walk away is the Silicon Docks area. And this has Google, LinkedIn, Airbnb, all the big new upcoming multinationals in that high tech space. So it's a very exciting part of the city to be situated in. And as I say, we're very fortunate to have the good neighbors that we do. And they work quite closely with us in terms of designing the programs that we deliver, but also inputting into those programs in terms of guest lectures, for example, and visiting the campus on a regular basis to either speak directly to students, but also to give them career advice, tips, and insight. Okay, so on employability then, the programs, like I say, are developed by industry for industry. So the top global companies sit on our advisory panels. But as I say, we also will invite our neighbors in to speak to our students, to give insights into particular issues. And it's a lovely way for students to interact and mix with big employers and to understand what are the main themes or trends that they're seeing within a particular area at any given time. It makes our programs very cutting edge. It keeps them up to date. And it's something that we're very, very proud of. I mentioned before our careers team. So we work very hard on our employability skills, particularly with our graduates. So we have an amazing careers team who work very closely with all of our students to make sure that you are graduate ready, that you are working on your CV, that you have a good LinkedIn profile, that you're building your network, that when it is time for you to go out and start to seek employment, that you're graduate ready, that you've had an opportunity to do a mock interview, that you received feedback on your CV, that you've been to a number of career events or fairs, so you understand what it is employers are looking for and how best to position yourself when you're in front of them. We have 100 plus campus career events annually, so we take this very seriously. And again, the more employers that we can bring to the college, we feel the better our students are prepared to go out into the world. And that's reflected in our success figures. So 91% of our bachelor degree graduates and 96% of our master's degree students are employed or in further study within 6 months of graduating. That's a very high percentage of individuals who find themselves in employment immediately following their completion of their course. And that's something that we think is really important, particularly for our international students, because as I say, it's a big investment, both financially and in terms of your time coming and traveling to Ireland. So it's very important to us that you're in a position to start to work as soon as possible after the completion of your study, particularly in an area though that is relevant to that program of study. So these are graduate roles. These are not roles in any organization. They're graduate roles, and we feel it's really important that our students continue to have access to those. And having all of those companies come and visit us is really how we manage to achieve that. Students always ask me, what are the typical starting salaries? And these are just typical starting salaries. It's very hard to be specific. And again, if you have their skill set or you're working in a particular area, they may vary higher or lower. But typically we see IT graduates starting between €35,000 to €55,000 and business graduates slightly less, 25,000 to 45,000. However, the business graduates tend to move quicker up through the organization. So while the salaries might be slightly lower upon starting, we tend to see business graduates move quicker through their career to the higher levels. So again, students ask me, that's why I include it. So again, what kinds of organizations do we see our graduates secure employment with? And this is just to give you a sample. Every year we do a first destination report where we look at in detail where all of our students' graduates have ended up. And our students are very good at telling us this information, but we also track them in terms of tracking them on LinkedIn. And what you can see here is some very strong brands where, again, our students have gone out and secured employment, SAP, IBM, Grant Thornton, Amazon, Bank of Ireland, Google, Microsoft, Facebook, they're all represented there. And what we find is once these organizations have taken one of our student graduates and they turn out to be very successful in their role, it makes them more likely to take on more. And we've been very lucky that our students to date have never let us down. And our reputation continues to grow within these organizations. And as those individuals move further and further up in their career, they remain very loyal to NCI, look for opportunities to bring in even more of our students. So again, we're very, very proud of our success in terms of our employability and our employability skills. So in terms of student experience then, you know, we think it's very important that we look after our students and that we support our students. We understand that students come to us with various different levels of ability maybe or skills that they've developed to date. And again, Ireland might have a different learning culture or structure than what you're used to previously. So we put in place a lot of supports to help students with that. And one of the key things that we would do is look to smaller class sizes. NCI is on a one campus site, so it's a relatively compact campus. So we're all together and you get to know the staff and the students very well. I would know my students by name. I would have an open door policy where any student can come to my door at any time and ask to speak to me, and I will welcome them in. We are very much an approachable institution because we really want to encourage our students to achieve their absolute ability. So again, in terms of academic support, we understand that some students might need a little bit of additional support, either to help them or to help them to achieve the highest grade that they're capable of. So we put in place academic writing supports, reading supports around research, studying, note-taking, exam revision, and so much more. And really our message is, if you're willing to work hard, we will match that in terms of the support that we will give you. We provide math support, and also there's a dedicated library help center, which really has a dedicated focus on international students and helping international students, particularly around assignments and the writing skills that are required for postgraduate students around the dissertation, for example. So we really invest in trying to put in place the supports for our students and to make sure that academically they're as fit as possible and do as well as possible to achieve their career goals. But we also understand as well that there's a world outside of academia. And again, it's important that we produce graduates who are well-rounded individuals. And increasingly that means looking after the well-being of the student, both physical and their mental health also. So the college invests quite significantly in this area. Students have access to the medical center and counseling services should they need it. There's free gym membership for international students to keep your mind and your body physically well. We have help desks in place. And then something that we find has been really positive in the past is this idea of international peer mentors, where some individuals who've been through this system before, who have experience of coming to Ireland for the first time from abroad and engaging in a program of study, are there to help and support newer students to the campus. And again, that can build great camaraderie, because some of the problems or the fears or concerns that you might have as a new student to Ireland are similar to what they experience themselves. So we find building this network of support around each other can be really helpful in terms of ensuring that you're as academically successful as possible while still having a very well-balanced and good lifestyle while you're here in Ireland. So the student experience, and again, this is more, I know this is, if my students were to say to me what I should say to potential students coming to Ireland, they would want me to say that Dublin is a very young city, it's a very beautiful city, and you can have a great time while you're studying here. The Irish people are very friendly, warm and open. And again, we have a great pub culture. We have great scenery. We have great historical features that you can visit. And genuinely, people love to meet new and interesting individuals, particularly from abroad, to understand their perspective, their insights, and their culture. As I mentioned before, where the college is located in the heart of the city centre. So again, you couldn't have a better location in terms of embedding yourself in the middle or the centre of all the hub, hustle and bustle and activity that there is within the city centre. We provide a 12-week preparation programme and free airport shuttle service. Again, this has been built over experience of feedback from students over time. What would help you be more successful in your programme? How can we bring you on board better? How can we help you to embed yourself into your studies quicker? And this is what they have told us. And that's why we put that 12-week preparation program in place. We provide accommodation guides. And again, the international team provide a welcome program, which is a 4-week program to learn about NCI, but also living in Dublin City. So where are the good shops? What's expensive? What's not? How does it work in terms of transportation? And what if I want to travel somewhere else? What should I do? So just an understanding, because in any new city, there are different ways and approaches. There are different tricks that might work well that the locals know. So it's important that we share those with our students. Obviously, we have a students' union then who have over 50 clubs and societies, and they have a social and event space. But we find with the students' union that the clubs and societies are increasingly reflecting our international students now. So we're seeing a rise in clubs and societies that maybe we wouldn't have seen previously. So we have here Gaelic football, for example, which is Irish football, where you can hold the ball in your hand, not soccer, it's different. But we're seeing, for example, our cricket club has absolutely boomed in recent years because of our Indian students coming on board. And actually, our cricket team are phenomenal because of that. So again, we're seeing a diversity in terms of our societies. And that's great because it allows an opportunity for us as Irish people to understand different cultures, but obviously for our international students to obviously mix and integrate with us as well. We have over 200 events each year specifically for our international students, again, to introduce you to Irish culture and to go on trips to visit some of our landmarks. And again, this is something that we have found is really positive to build, I suppose, confidence, but also friends and networks within the college. So that's a lot about Ireland and Dublin and the National College of Ireland. So I suppose it's only right that we should revisit what you can study and what you can study, particularly in my school, which is the School of Business. As I said, we have undergraduate and postgraduate courses. So you can see the undergraduate programs are listed on the left-hand side. They're level 8 honours degree programs. So the duration is usually 3 years, unless you choose to take an additional year to undertake an internship between your third and fourth year. And again, we find that that is quite popular, particularly with the accounting and finance degree, for example, where some of our students will go and work with some of the big accountancy firms to get experience. And where they do that, they find that upon completion of their degree, they usually move into a position within those organizations afterwards. It's increasingly becoming popular. And again, it's something that we would encourage and recommend. But it's very important to us that the work experience or the internship that's undertaken is one that has real value. So we work very hard to make sure that you find the right placement in the right industry. So we have degrees in business, accounting and finance, human resource management, marketing practice and psychology. And again, they're equally all very popular. And again, the graduate employment rates coming out of each of those programs are all very high. We tend to see quite a high market for business graduates in general in the Irish environment. But again, some of our students will obviously choose to go on and pursue a master's award. And again, degrees from all of these programs will allow students to access any master's program in a business-related discipline. So then in terms of our graduate programs, we have an MSc in Management, an MSc in International Business, an MA in Human Resource Management, an MSc in Entrepreneurship, an MSc in Finance, and an MSc in Marketing. These are one-year taught degrees. So again, these allow you, are very popular with our international students. They're very condensed programs, but sometimes they can give you an edge in terms of the employment market, separate you from maybe those with a degree. And again, if you can combine that with some international travel, or if you combine it with some work experience over the summer months, then it tends to make the student very attractive to employers. So in terms of fees, and again, it's to acknowledge that yes, programs and education can be expensive, but I would point to the fact that the salaries that people earn having completed their program of study are actually very high. And as I said before, for our business graduates, they tend to move quite quickly through the layers to higher management levels. So the undergraduate programs are currently 10,000 euros per year. However, we do offer a scholarship of euros against that. The higher diplomas, of which in the School of Business we don't have any, are 12,000, but the master's programs, which we do have, are 15,000 euros with a 2,000 or 4,000 scholarship, depending on your GPA. We do offer currently a Future Leaders program, which is a 50% scholarship, but again, my colleagues can talk to you about the qualifying criteria around that. We just feel that it's very important that we are promoting future leaders and that we're looking to identify those and offer them incentives in order to be successful in their careers. So how can you apply should you be interested in coming to NCI? Well, again, it depends on the program of study, but in general, it's relatively straightforward and we work very hard to try to make it as streamlined as possible for you. And again, it's important to say that we put in a lot of supports and resources around trying to help and assist any applicant in terms of applying to the college. So if you have questions or queries, if you're unsure of an answer, if you would like some more information, we would encourage you to make contact either through your agent or through the educational supports that we have in place. And we're more than happy to answer those. It's important that students are happy insofar as they can be, that they've made the right choice for them. And we feel very confident in the college that we provide an excellent educational experience. And so we're more than happy to deal with students in relation to that. So all undergraduate programs, we would look for an approved high school diploma, including maths and English. Some students will require a foundation or pathway program. And again, we'll help you to understand whether or not you fall into that criteria. For School of Business Masters, we look for a four-year bachelor degree in any major. MSc and MSc in Marketing have slight restrictions to them. But again, if you ask us or tell us what you have, we'll work through it with you to help you understand whether or not you're eligible. The MSc in Marketing looks for a business major with extensive marketing modules. And similarly, our MSc in Finance will also look to see that you have some finance or accounting included in the major that you've completed. And again, that's just because, particularly with our MSc in Finance, it's very quantitative based, it's heavily maths orientated. And in order for our students to be successful on that program, it's important that you understand that before you commence and that you have the skill set to allow you to be successful. Because for me as the dean of the school, it's important that all of our students are successful on their program of study. We really don't want to be taking on students who are going to struggle in a program that they have chosen to do. And sometimes we might have to advise you or direct you towards a different master's program, which might actually be more beneficial to you and your future career than allowing you onto a program where you might struggle. So again, as I say, as a team, we're more than happy to help you in terms of understanding the entry requirements. and helping you to navigate your way through that. And you can ask us any questions, because we understand that students will come forward with very different learning profiles, and no two are usually the same. In terms of English language requirements, and again, this is really important. This is an area where we do see that student success is very closely linked to their English language ability. So we do look for students to have, particularly for master's programs, a 6.5 overall in terms of their IELTS level, and for our undergraduate programs, a 6 in terms of their IELTS. And again, for me, what I tend to see is those students who have struggled in the past, it's because their English language hasn't been at the level that it needed to be to allow them to be successful in the program. Where that occurs, we just look to put in place additional supports for those individuals. So it's not a case that we leave them behind. We will always work with you to try to ensure that you're successful. But we do know from experience that these are the English language requirements which are more likely to make you successful on your program of study. Okay, so the admissions process, how does it work? Well, we would advise as a first port of call that you research and select the program that you're most interested in. The fact that you're on this call today probably is a sign that you're already started that process, so well done to you. Once you've decided the program that you're most likely to be interested in, we would suggest that you check the entry requirements. And if you have questions or queries around that, that you contact us and we'll help to guide you through it. Then you need to begin the process of preparing your documents. And again, given the year that we've all been through globally, we understand that there are some restrictions in terms of institutions' ability to provide certificates and copies of awards and degrees. Again, the admissions team will help to guide you through that process should that be a difficulty for you. We would ask you then to apply online or through an NCI approved education agent, of which you have great ones. You would receive your official offer letter and fulfill any conditions of your offer. And again, we would only ever place a condition on an offer where we felt it was very important for you to be successful on the program. So these aren't intended ever to be a barrier towards you coming onto the program. It's more that we feel that these are important that you have in place in order for you to be successful. And we would ask you then to pay your tuition fees. You can then begin the process of applying for your study visa. And at that point, then we'll start to connect you with NCI and the other students in our pre-arrival events. And after all of that, it's just a small matter of traveling to Dublin and to commence your program of study. I suppose as the Dean of School, I have to say that every year when we get to graduation and to the end of the programs, I'm always excited to hear the student feedback. And we're very proud of the fact that up to now, we have very positive student feedback, particularly from our international students. Our students enjoy their time studying at the college. They enjoy the interaction with their colleagues. They enjoy the experience of being in Ireland, which is so important. And most of them are fortunate enough to go on and secure really good employment on the back of it, which has to be the primary goal of any institution. So I'm really proud of the success that we've had in that regard. So if you have any queries in relation to NCI, I would ask you to contact my colleagues who are coming up here on the last slide. You'll be glad to know. But again, I'm conscious that you might have lots of questions on the back of this. And that's the whole idea of a session like this, is that you can now reach out and ask those questions of us and my colleagues, and we are happy to guide you through that process. This is a big step, and it's one that we want you to be very happy with. So we're more than happy to invest the time in terms of helping you to understand our requirements and to make sure that we find the right course for you to allow you to be successful going forward. So I really hope that that has given you a good sense of Ireland, of Dublin, and of the National College of Ireland. I genuinely hope that at some stage, hopefully over the next few months, that maybe I'll be welcoming you onto campus in the National College of Ireland. And should that be the case, then please do pop up and say hello. I'd be delighted to see a face having known we met virtually in this environment to begin with. So again, my thanks for your time this afternoon. And I wish you all the very best in terms of your future studies, wherever they may be. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Colette. That was wonderful. I think you covered everything. And, you know, somebody who's not aware about Ireland also, they would be able to pass on the messages to the applicants. So that was like a lot in detail, which is very, very helpful. There are a couple of questions which I was just taking. So somebody is interested in knowing about the employability situation, like how it was in 2020 and has it improved in 2021? So would you be able to shed some light on that?
Yeah, so obviously it's a time of great uncertainty, I suppose, globally, given what we have been through. But actually the Irish economy continues to grow. And we see that by the most recent returns and the exchequer figures that we're looking at. I think it is fair to say, though, that maybe our small and medium-sized organizations in terms of indigenous organizations are struggling maybe more than the bigger multinationals, who seem to be less affected by the pandemic. But again, all of the indicators would seem to be predicting that we will be able to navigate this quite well. And our expectations are that GDP growth, for example, will continue to thrive over the next 5 years. And economists seem to be pointing to the fact that actually it might just be the smaller local organizations that might take a temporary dip, but actually the larger employers look to be well positioned to navigate their way through it. Certainly in terms of employer engagement in the college, we have found that to be as high as ever. We're not hearing anything from our bigger employers that they are looking to cut back or curtail the number of graduates that they're taking on. But I do think there's just slight nervousness in the system at the minute, as there is globally in terms of what's going to happen next. But there's nothing in terms of what we can see that would make us worried for the time being.
Yeah, thanks a lot for taking that one.
That's no problem.
Yeah, some of them are asking about the requirements in finance. So, you know, we tried explaining it to them that the majority of the modules need to be from finance, because if it's a BCom or an honors degree, we just need to see some modules, because the MSc finance would require the students to have that. So any comments?
So, yeah. So our MSc Finance is more focused on the back office operation side of it. So it's quite closely aligned to the CFA, the Chartered Financial Analyst designation, which is an American designation. So that's very high. It's highly sought after and highly regarded, but it also is very quantitative based. So it's very much based on numbers. And if you haven't had experience of developing that skill set over the course of your bachelor's degree, then you may struggle on the MSc in finance. And so that's why we ask students to show us, in terms of the modules that they have covered to date, what level of exposure they've had to those tools and techniques. Because again, we know that that makes them more likely to be successful on the program. And for me, it's very important that we don't take a student onto a program where they're likely to struggle. And it's important that those students who attempt these degrees and can be successful on them.
Yeah, all right. I think that is very well explained for the counselors also available, because it was a question from a counselor who asked me. Yeah, that's about it. And there are some questions which we can take it. It's about application processes and about the English language requirements, which we can take definitely. But I would like to thank you again, Colette, and it was a very short notice that we gave you, and sorry about the two intro, but it was really, really helpful. I think a lot of students will be viewing it. We'll also spread the word amongst the offer holders who already hold offers with NCI. So if there is anything, I will definitely reach out to you. But guys, do you guys have anything else? Because I think that was great, and no questions from my side. Thanks a lot.
So there are a few questions if you'd like to take it.
Then I'll take it, Jyotsna. Okay.
Well, just to say from my side, it's been really enjoyable. I really enjoy these events. You probably get a sense that I probably spend too much time with my students, but it's really important that you get a sense and a flavor for the institution that we are and how we really do value, you know, that student interaction piece. We really want our students to be successful and have the best chance that they can to achieve their career goals. So we work really hard to do that. So any chance I get to speak directly to applicants, I'm delighted to do it. And as I say, hopefully I'll get to see some of you in September as you join us in NCI for your program of study.
Excellent. Colette, I would like to, you know, take this opportunity and thank you for this interesting presentation about the business school. We appreciate having you address our audience, definitely. I mean, just to remind the audience, Dr. Colette herself is the dean of the business school and an Irish graduate, having studied at Trinity and University of Limerick. So this session could not have gotten any better. So we highly appreciate your time, Doctor. Any students who are looking to, you know more about studying in Ireland and to learn more about NCI, you can visit idp.com to connect with our counselors who can, you know, further assist you with your study abroad decisions. And Apeksha, if you're taking any more questions, we take. Otherwise, we can end the session if you.
I would actually like Colette to just stay back for a picture. We'll ask everybody to switch on the cameras and just take one photo. And after that, she can leave the session. It's all about the application process. So me and Bhavna can take this.
So we'll end the session on the Facebook Live, and then we can like stay back for.
Yes, exactly. So guys, I request all of you, can you please switch on your video for a minute, just for a picture?
Let us know once you've taken that.
Okay, Jyotsna, just hold on. One second, sorry. Okay. Thanks, guys. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much.
Super. Thank you. Thank you to your colleagues in IDB, and obviously to Peshka and all my great friends over there in One Step. And I look forward to seeing you all soon.
Yeah. Thank you, Colette. You have a good day. Thank you, Peksha.
You too. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone, for joining in. We'll end the session now. Thank you.